Hey everyone, welcome back. My name's Greg and you are watching Introduction to Appian Interfaces. Now in this video, we're going to explore how you can quickly generate interfaces for create, update, and delete. Now don't forget, like, subscribe, and comment to see more videos like this one and check out our other relevant resources linked in the description below. All right, let's get started. All right, so there's two different ways that you can create interfaces. One is from scratch. When you create a new interface, you can drag and drop the components or get started using patterns or even templates. But the other way is using a feature within the record object where you can quickly generate actions like create, update, and delete and the supporting objects like interfaces. All right, so here we are in the record object. And as you'll notice, I already have a data model created for my contact form. First name, last name, email, and phone number, as well as some generic other data fields created on, created by, and status. Now, what I want to do is I want to be able to create new contacts, update contacts, or even delete contacts. So I'm going to move on over here to the left-hand side, and under interfaces, I'm going to click actions. So here I have the ability to add actions to my record, and I'm going to go ahead and click generate record actions. All right, now when we're creating these actions, I have the ability to choose to do create, update, and delete, or perhaps just create, not update or delete, depending on what you're trying to do. I'm going to keep these the same, and I'm going to click customize. Now, if you wanted to change the display names of these actions, new contact, update contact, delete contact, or the description, you can do it here. For my purpose, though, I'm just going to click next. All right, so what it's going to do is it's going to create four new objects and use four existing objects. Pretty cool. So here we can see it's going to create a process model, create or update contact, and the interface, create or update contact. Also for the delete action, it's going to do the delete contact interface and the delete contact process model. And then it's using these four existing objects for security and organization. Now, if at any point you want to change which group it's using for security or folder it's using for organization, just click the pencil icon and replace with an existing object. Okay, so let's hit generate. So what it's doing is it's now creating those objects in the background. It's creating those processes. It's creating functional processes as well as those interfaces. Now, once these are created, we can now go back to our list of objects and edit and enhance them. Great. So we can see that these actions have now been created. Awesome. What I'm going to do now is move over to my list of objects back in Appian Designer. I'm going to go ahead and refresh so that way I can see these objects now. And here they are. We have our two process models for create or update contact and delete contact. And then we have our interface, create or update contact, and the other interface delete contact. So let's take a look at what happened when it generated my create or update contact interface. All right, so here we have the create contact form. We've got our first name field, last name, email, phone number, and even a status. Now the status is a record picker since within my record object, I had a choice list relationship. Now what we would do is just enhance this. Start moving these things around into an order that just makes more sense. Who knows? Let's just move things around as an example here. Maybe first name and last name should be the first. Email and then phone number over here. And maybe what I want is I want status to actually be the very last one in the second column. Cool. You'll also notice we have some pre-configurations here with character length validations, and they're already mapped to our rule inputs. Now these rule inputs are needed to pass information in and out of the interface. So when it created these for us, it automatically included those rule inputs and mapped them. So now it's actually 100% functional. Now, once you're done moving things around, don't forget to hit save changes and then go to that record object and check out the record list, and you will see those actions for new and those related actions for update and delete. All right, and that's it. I'll see you all in the next one.